Even though they were smaller than all the other animals in the village, Anansi the Spider was known for their cunning and bravery. One day, Anansi heard a loud banging on the door. They opened it to Vulcan the Wolf from the local committee. "Good day, Anansi. Please take this leaflet about our plans for the village reading circle. Goodbye." Once he had left, Anansi read the leaflet and was shocked. They marched right down to the reading circle to speak to Yakini the goat, the village storyteller. "How can the committee decide to get rid of the reading circle to build more caves for only the wolves?" Anansi exclaimed. She responded, "I know, I can't think of anything we could do. Yakini, we must come up with a plan to stop them. Let's get everyone together and do something about this." Every animal from Perico, the pink-backed pelican, to Badua, the bush-backed sender, upon the reading circle in a rage. "This isn't fair," Pariku proclaimed. "Where are we supposed to hear stories?" They all loudly agreed. "The committee hasn't even given us enough time. They're going to be building the cave next week," Badua barked. All the animals roared and yelled in discontent. "Quiet," Yakini moved from the front to restore peace. "Let's calm down and hatch a plan. Anansi, we could do with your craftiness. What do you think?" All the animals present turned to look at Anansi, who was deep in thought. After a moment of silence, Anansi finally spoke up. "I've got it."
The day came for the caves to be built, and the reading circle was surrounded by shovel, spade, and wheelbarrows. Sneakily, led by Anansi and Yakini, the animals took their places around the circle, holding hands. Anansi quickly worked their magic, spinning a web around the tools. Vulcan and the local committee heard a hullabaloo from far away and went down to see what was going on. "Move, so we can get on with the building," Vulcan shouted. "No," said the animals. "We will not move." Again, Vulcan told them to move, but again, they refused. Although they were frightened, Anansi sprung into action, calling all the birds to flap their wings, the baboons to beat their chests, the hogs to grunt, all causing a commotion. Each time the wolves got closer, the animals would get louder. Eventually, knowing they could not get through and overwhelmed by the noise, the wolves backed away. Soaking in defeat, Vulcan reluctantly piped up, "Fine, keep your wretched reading circle." All the animals cheered in celebration. Yakini turned to Anansi. "I can't believe we did it. I thought it was going to be impossible." Anansi replied, "Even when things seem hopeless, there's always a way when we come together."